Good morning and good afternoon, everybody on live and on replay. Welcome to another workout today. Today we're going to be focused on bar moves. We have not done this one in a while, so hopefully you guys will enjoy it and keep up with it. So let's get started with some stretching. Go ahead and take a big step back. Lean into a lunge position, slowly drop that back leg down to the ground, and then lean into it. Forward as far as you can comfortably go. Feel that deep stretch, hold it there. 3, 2, 1, slowly bring it back. Up to your feet, switch sides, big step back, lean into it, lunge position. Slowly drop that back leg down to the ground and then lean into it. Hold it in your deepest position for 3, 2, 1. Somebody's trying to get in. Let me just let them in real quick. Okay, come back up to your feet. Wide stance. Slide down to your left ankle, keeping that leg straight as possible. Hands go up. Slide up to your right side and down, keeping that leg straight. Great. Bring yourself back up to center and then back down to the left side, keeping that leg straight as possible. Slide it up and over, down to the other side. Good, back up to center, inhale. Raising your arms up to the ceiling and then down to the ground. And slowly roll yourself back up. Another deep inhale. Arms go up and then down to the ground. Yourself back up one more time. Bring your feet to center and high knees. Nice and slow, just stretching out those muscles. Okay, let's bring it to the back. 3, 2, 1, and forward. Big arm circles. Getting all those muscle groups moving. Let's reverse it. Big arm circles. Good. Okay, lastly, let's go up to our neck and slowly pull down to our right shoulder. And then up and over to our left. Deep breath. And then up and over to our right again. Try and go a little bit further down this time around. And then up and over to the other side. Try and go a little bit further than you did the last time without hurting yourself, just gently. Gently pull. Good. Bring it back to center. Bring your chin to chest and roll it from shoulder to shoulder. Shrug your shoulders, up, back, and around. Up, back, and around. And reverse it, pull it back, up, forward, and down. Good, okay. So, for today, you might wanna have a chair handy. So, just a chair handy, either to your left, right, or center, or something that you can move around with. You don't have to have it, but it may help with stability. Okay, so I'll have one handy on both sides for the camera's sake, but you could just switch sides of your chair versus I can't because of the camera. Okay, so remember with BARRE, we just don't stop, right? So I'm just getting my notes up. Okay, adjusting the camera. Okay, ready? So our first one that we're going to start off with, just to warm up all the muscles, is a simple chair squat. So we're gonna have feet in line with our shoulders. We are going to bring it down. Now when I bring it down, want your face to not be too far forward in front of your knees. Remember, this is too far forward. Bring that back up so that your center of gravity is more straight. If that means you can't go as far down, that's okay. Just stay here, as long as you're not passing too far in front of your knees. Because that changes our pressure. Sorry, choking. Okay, I'm gonna have to just work out because I'm choking. Okay, let's get started. Ready? 3, 2, 1. Down, press up with your heels. If you wanna hold your light weights, you can. Just warming everything up. Whew. Getting it warmed up. 3, 2, and 1. Good. Okay. So grab those light weights. We're gonna go into a little bit wider stance. So just past your shoulders, squat down to center, then back up. That's it. Okay, so we're gonna go through the motions of our squats. Ready and go. Keep that center of gravity as straight up and down as you possibly can, like you're sitting down into a chair. And then popping up, push up from your heels as you're coming up, not your toes. Your toes are just there for stability. 3, 2, and 1. Good, kind of shake it off. We've got one more sumo squat. So go to your wide stance, just past your shoulders, and then go a little bit further. As comfortably as you can go. Then from here, we're gonna go down and then up. Okay, ready? Down and up. Think about those heels again. You should be feeling this in your inner thigh. Inner thighs and center glutes. Same thing, you're gonna sit down on a stool. Should be getting warmed up. And good, stop. Walk it off. Gonna go up to our arms. For this one, we are not gonna stop. We're gonna go continuously through the moves. Everyone can do the same thing, level 1 and 2. Just adjust your weights, okay? We're just working with light weights today. You don't need heavy weights, but if you would like to go heavier, that's up to you. Okay, so hands on your side, by your hips, lift and lower. Just like so. Keep those arms straight. Posture nice and straight. Almost there. Three, two, and one. Bring those arms forward, straight in front of you. Lift. Level one, if this is getting to be too much, you can alternate your sides, left and right. Otherwise, keep that posture nice and straight, spine straight. Keep it going. Three, two, and one. Let's take it to the back. We're going to do tricep lifts. So solid on your feet, just a little bit forward. Hands at your waist, lift and lower. Ready and go. Stop it at your hips. We don't want to swing past our hips. Feel the burn. Three, two, and one. Good. Back to center. Roll those shoulders a bit. Hands to your side. Ready, round two. Lift and lower. Roll those shoulders, bring your hands forward, center lift. Level one, you can alternate if you need. Let's go. Arms are nice and straight. Almost there. Three, two, and one. Bring it to the back. Ready? And go. Bring them up as high as you can comfortably go. Almost there. Feel the burn. Three, two, and one. Woo! Drop those weights. Then go back down to our legs. So you can feel the resistance even with lighter weights. And that's what we want. If you need to grab a sip of water, go ahead. Okay, here's where our legs are going to come in handy. I mean, our chairs are gonna come in handy for our legs. Okay, first one, we're gonna start off with our right leg. Lateral lift out to the side. Keep it all straight, okay? Body is nice and straight. We're not leaning into the chair, just using the chair for support. Ready? And go. So try and keep your body as straight as possible. We don't want to be leaning off to the side. Just pull that center of gravity up and lift your legs as high as you can comfortably go. Tap the ground and repeat. Deep breaths. You don't have to lean into the chair. You could work without the chair. Just work on your balance and stop. Good, right leg still, bringing it forward. Same thing, bring your foot out, lift, tap the ground, and repeat. Let's go. So remember with bar, we don't have to use a lot of weights, we just don't rest very much. So that lactic acid builds up, and you can feel the burn. Remember to breathe. Three, two, one. Great job, feel that burn. We're gonna stick with that right leg. This time we're going back. Tap the leg to the ground and then back. Okay, here we go, right leg. Try and keep yourself straight up. We're not leaning into it, keeping it straight. A slight forward tilt is just natural because you're balancing the weight of your back leg, but we're just not leaning into it. Tap the ground and bring it up. Straight leg. Three, two, and one. Woo! Good job. We got one more on the right side. We're gonna go circles. So, we're going to bring our foot slightly forward and go around. So we're gonna go clockwise for small circles, and then we'll go counterclockwise for small circles. Right leg still. Here we go. Bring that leg up. Small circles. Breathe. Bar moves really get into all those minor muscle groups that we talked about. That's why sometimes it becomes more challenging than you would think. Because you're like, wait, this is so simple. Why is it burning? Three, two, one. Bring it down. Shake that leg. Get some of that lactic acid out. Okay, we're going to go counterclockwise now. Same leg, right leg. Here we go. Lift. Counter. Okay, left side. So, back to our lateral lift. Ready? Out. Straight leg, not leaning into the chair too much. Try and keep that center of gravity straight up. Lift it out. Tap the ground. Bring it back up. Almost there. Three, two, and one. Next one. Bringing it to the front. Point that leg straight out in front and lift. Breathe in. Breathe through the burn. Three, two, and one. Walk it off for a second. We're gonna take it to the back. Left leg. Straight leg lift. Ready. And go. Step it back and lift. Circles. Just breathe. should be feeling hot. The heat is coming up. Three, two, and one. Big steps before we go into counterclockwise. Okay, counterclockwise. Straight through. Do the best you can. This is also working our hip muscles. Our opposite leg is supporting us. And stop. Good. Walk it off. Reach down. Woo, stretch out those legs. Get some of that lactic acid built up. Out. Why? Because we have to do round two. And round two, you're going to feel it even more. So just give it a second. Couple of stretches. Let yourself hang. Slowly roll yourself up. Okay, round two will be harder because your muscles are already warmed up, fatigued, and building lactic acid, so they're already starting to break down. So second round, if you need to go a little slower, just try to push through it and keep it consistent. It will pay off later with the new muscle tissue. So back to our right leg, we have lateral lifts. Ready, and go. Almost there. Keep it going. Three, two, and one. Take it to the front. Frontal lifts. Tap and go. Right leg still. Work on that straight posture, center of gravity. Two and one. Woo. Gonna take it to the back. You should feel that burn. Straight to the back. Right leg. Lift and lower. Not too far over. Just a slight lean. Right leg. Tap the ground. Bring it up. If you want more intensity, go faster. If you want less intensity, go slower. Three, two, and one. Walk it off for a second. We have circles. Good, right leg. Clockwise, small circles. Deep breath. Continue to breathe. Three, two, and one. Walk it off for a second before we go to counterclockwise. Okay, counterclockwise. Small circles. If the burn gets to be too much, you can just stand up, stop for a second, and then come back in. Woo, feeling it. Try to breathe through it. Straight leg. Three, two, and one. Walk it off. So even that supporting leg is starting to feel it just standing there, right? Okay, going to switch sides, round two. Here we go, lateral lifts, left side. Tap and bring it out. Try and keep your body straight. Three, two, and one. Frontal lifts is next. Left side, ready, and go. Breathe in. We're doing it together. I don't ask you to do anything I'm not doing. Breathe in. Try and keep that leg straight, body straight, posture straight. Three, two, and one. Walk it off. Taking it to the back. Left side. Ready? And go. Inside my body because it's not really hot in here. Okay, we have our circles, left side, clockwise. Get ready and go. Coming up. Ready and go. Left side. Almost there. Three, two, and one. Walk it off. Great job, guys. Light stretch. Just lean over for a bend. Let yourself hang there. Slowly roll yourself up. I know. Grab some water. It's hot. So, I always like to remind you, I know BARRE seems a little bit slower than what we're used to with some of our other resistance training, but you feel it in the motions because of its repetitiveness. Okay, let's go up to our arms again. So, with our arms, we are going to not stop again, okay? So, first one, bring it up, bent elbows, open and close. Squeeze those shoulder blades as you're pulling it back. Keep those elbows up. Breathe in. Okay, drop it down. Slight bend forward, straight spine, bringing it into rows. Squeeze those shoulder blades again. Three, two, and one. Bring it back up. Press up and down. Breathe. Almost there. Three, two, and one. Drop it down. Round two. Bring them back up, elbows up, open and close. Starting already. Squeeze those shoulder blades. Three, two, and one. Drop it down to rows. Pull those shoulders back. Squeeze your shoulder blades. Elbows up. Three, two, and one. Bring it back up to press. Ready, go. Remember to breathe. Three, two, and one, drop it down. Okay, good job. We're gonna take it down to the mat. Okay, so slight variation of something that we've done before. Gonna come onto all fours. Keep your feet spread out just past your shoulders behind you. So when you look down, they're just slightly to the side of your shoulders. Your hands, however, are directly below your shoulders for support. And then we're gonna come up on from our knees. We're gonna come up off the ground. Okay, so. Level one, this may be a little bit tricky for you, but just do what you can, and if you cannot float on the ground with your knees up, then you just, you know, bring them back down to the ground and do the moves that we're gonna do, but your knees touching the ground, okay? So for level one, but just try. So hands are below your shoulders, feet are just past your shoulders, and then we're floating our knees up. And then from here, we're going to kick down, kick up and down, but we're gonna keep those knees floating. You see that? We're not dropping them down. Level one, you can bring it up and down like so, but if you could try and float, that would be good. Okay, but if your wrist can't handle it, or if you just can't handle it, then you just go on all fours, okay? So we're going to do 20 total, 10 on each side. So no timer, just counting. And our main focus is to try and keep our knees floating, okay? So here we go. Floating knees. One, two, three, four, three, keep those knees floating. Four, five, if this is too hard on your knees, six, then go ahead and drop them down, that's okay. Seven, eight, nine, 10, halfway there. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, and 10, drop it down. Woo! So that really works your core, your shoulders, your back, and your legs. So that one's a pretty intense move. So level one, or anybody with knee issues, you're gonna just be on all fours for that one, okay? So come up for a breather. You're gonna roll it over. Clear your mat, we're gonna lay down. We are gonna do a slight variation of a crunch. So, going to lay flat. Going to bring one leg up. Bring our hands behind our head to support our neck and head. We're going to crunch it to only one side, up and down, with one leg held up. Level one, just do the best you can. If you cannot keep your leg up the whole time, then you're just gonna be crunching to one side, okay? So, we can do this. These are just different moves, different variations of moves we've always done. So, gonna count to 15 on this side. So, straight leg, ready? One, all the way down, two, all the way down. So up, three, and down. Four, try and get that bigger crunch in. Five, six, all the way down. Seven, eight, nine, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, and stop. We're gonna switch sides now. Bring the right leg up. Ready? And go. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, and 10. Almost there. 11, 12, 13, all the way up, all the way down, 14, and 15. Woo, bring it down. Roll it to your side, and back up again. We're gonna go back into our floating knees. So, if you cannot do this because it hurts, please don't do it. Or if you have an injury that you're trying to kind of baby with your knees, I know a couple of you guys do have issues with that. So just go on all fours and pretty much do like a donkey kick with our foot trying to reach the ceiling versus keeping your knees floating, okay? So, hands below your shoulders, feet just past your shoulders behind you. Come up into a floating stance. Ready? And one, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10, 11, 12, going to 20, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, and 20. Good job. Woo! Roll it back. Breathe in. Gonna go down to the ground. Second round of those crunches. So level one with this one, you can keep your feet planted or you can lift it up. just do the best you can. Okay, we have 15. One leg down, one leg up. Ready and go. One, two. Try and get those elbows and knees to touch. Three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, and we're done. One for good measure. Right side, same thing. Ready and go. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, drop it down. Woo! Drop it down. Good job, you guys. Roll it over. We are almost through. Great work. We're going to come back up to our feet. Grab some water. The heat is definitely intensified. So remember, you don't have to be working super fast to have results. Your muscles don't know speed and reps, they just know once it gets to a breakdown point, you know. So as you get stronger, that increases as well. Okay. Gonna go back to our legs. You may need the chair. You can grab one weight for your supporting side. We're gonna do one side at a time. And get our timer. Okay, so everything we did at first, our leg was straight. So now we're going to bend it. So another part of BARRE is bent movements. So we're just gonna, this weight is just for extra resistance. We're not gonna do anything with our arms. It's just if you wanna have more resistance while you're doing your leg. You're gonna bring it up to a 90 degree angle and bring it out. Okay, so these moves are gonna be bent leg. The first one was all about straight leg, so that's the main difference. Okay, so here we go. Right leg, bring it up, open and close. That's it. Keep your posture nice and straight. Breathe in. Really working your hip flexors here. Three, two, and one. Good job. Whew. Next one. You're going to bring that leg up and down. Up and down. So it's a slight bend. Up and a tap back. Up, tap back. Okay? So. Still with the bent leg, ready? Up, step back. Up, step back. Breathe in. It's not a far step back, it's just a step back. That supporting leg is kind of feeling it right now. Woo! Three, two, and one, good job. Okay, Lastly, for the bent leg, we're gonna bring it up. So it's more of a crunch. Crunch. Not quite all the way down, so just bring it up. Crunch. 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 We're not really bringing it down to the ground though, okay? So if it goes low, that's fine. But let's try and keep it floating. We're bringing that crunch up. So before it was bringing it down, now we're bringing it up. Okay, bend the leg. Crunch. Crunch. Breathe in. Whoo. Last one and done. Oh, that supporting leg. Feeling it over there. Walk it off. Switching sides. Switching sides. Okay, here we go. Hold that weight. Bring it up, nice triangle. Open and close. Drop it down. Bringing the knee up with a tap back. Weight on your shoulder. Knee up, tap back. I look kind of funny at this over there. Okay, there it goes. As I get to the edge of the screen, it kind of fisheyes, so I look like I was really turned. Bring it all the way up and down. We're not going fast. Slow is how we get the burn. Three, two, and one. Woo! That supporting leg is feeling it. Okay, bringing that bent leg up to a crunch. Here we go. Bend, crunch, crunch. Float your foot off the ground. Doesn't have to touch. If it touches, you know, it's not a deal breaker, but we're trying to bring the intensity up by keeping it floating. A standing crunch, pretty much. Woo! Three, two, and one. Drop it down. Good job, you guys. Woo! Only a couple more minutes. Walk it off. Grab your other weight. We're gonna finish it off with 2 minutes of full body and some cardio. So just get some of that lactic acid out. You're gonna need some extra space in the muscles for the next one, okay? Okay, so you know the drill. I call out different moves. We're gonna switch it all around, but we're not gonna stop. So this is gonna be high intensity and cardio. Ready? Grab your light weights. Bring it to the center and punch it out. Three, two, and one. Bring it to high knees. Bring it up. Big step. If you want to go quicker, you can go quicker. Gonna take it to side punch next. Shift your weight left to right, okay? Three, two, and one. Shift, shift. Thank you. three, two, and one. Press, press. Keep it quick. Keep it quick. Gonna go into squats. Ready, three, two, and one. Bring those weights center. Press it up from your heels. Next, we're gonna have battle ropes. In three, two, and one. good. Let's bring it to your center and then to your right. Left side goes over. Them out today. Oh, boy, how'd you guys do? I see everybody huffing and puffing. Oops. Zoom's getting all these new add-ons and I don't know what I'm pushing. Nice to see you all live. Let's get a smile for the camera. 1, 2, 3, cheese. Good. Oh my goodness. So we are almost to the end of August. I can't believe it. Here we are. I'm going to be sending out an email with in between like over sometime over the weekend or something. So just be on the lookout for it. I'm going to do a little survey of everybody that is, you know, been part of the class and just see how you guys are doing, how you guys are feeling. And then also what your plans are and schedule is going to be like going forward into September. I know there's a lot of things kind of changing in the world and going back to how things were before COVID. And we started the whole Zoom thing specifically because of lockdown. And it's just kind of turned into this really great, group environment, which I really have come to love. But I just want to see where you guys are also, because I know people's schedules will be changing and, you know, getting back out into the public and, you know, field and stuff. So just want to see that. And then I also have a couple more ideas coming up as far as, I'm going to be going into a little bit more nutrition side of things and using my nutritional certifications and stuff to maybe try and do some classes for nutrition. So I'll explain that in the email. And I just want to see what everybody's feel is on that, because although exercise is super important, nutrition is even more important. So I feel like there more people need also nutrition than just movement. So obviously they go hand in hand, but they go better when they're combined. So I want to maybe open up a new avenue of things with a nutritional class as well. So just seeing how I'm going to see how everybody feels about that. And it's not going to be like public. You're just going to be talking to me about your feelings. If you have any ideas of what you think people need or ways that I can be of more assistance to people, helpful, then let me know, because I've had a lot of people come and go in the class and they really like it. But commitment is the hardest part with anything. People have a hard time committing. And I just want to try and help everybody in a way that they can sustain it, you know, because a diet is only good for a diet, you know, a short period of time, and an exercise challenge is only good for, you know, 30 days. And then people go back to the couch. So really, it's about sustainability and how people can continue their lifestyle. You know, I know them all. It's like, okay, let's do this 30-day challenge, right? And it's like, get your friends in. Everybody does it for 30 days. And they're like, okay, I'm good, right? I'm done for the rest of the year. No, sorry, you have to keep moving. So anyway, just want to let you guys know, give you a heads up. There's going to be an email, and I would appreciate your feedback.
before the end of the month, and we'll see how things are going. I am going to be also taking a short vacation in the end of September. So we haven't gone anywhere since moving to Guam. And we're going to be gone for about 3 weeks. So I'll probably be doing some sort of replay option for those times. And just, you know, keeping in contact with everybody weekly with emails and stuff and accountability through email, and make you, you know, send me a picture that you did it, so that it keeps you accountable. You're not going on vacation. We're all going to keep moving, just at different times. So, I don't want to take any more of your time, but I just want to keep everybody on the same page. And I would appreciate your feedback, to let me know how we can move forward in a healthy way going forward. Okay. Great. I really appreciate all of you guys, and on replay, everybody watching. I appreciate you all. So we'll talk to you soon. Bye.